All right, guys. So I recently had a chance to finish the Echo series on Disney Plus, and I wanted to kind of give you my thoughts on just the series overall, not specifically particular episode breakdowns, but what I thought overall for the particular series, and more along the lines of like the questions I have for the overall future of the character. First and foremost, this is a spoiler review. I am going to touch on some things. So if you haven't seen it, definitely make sure you go actually and watch this before you hear what I have to say in this particular kind of quasi review, but I don't want to spoil anything for anybody. So if you haven't seen it, go watch it and then come back. And if you don't care, just go ahead and just sit through and listen to me talk. Now, like I said, this is going to be an overall thing. And my first question is, I'm not sure who this show was for. Overall in the show, it was kind of a mess. It had some positives and it had some negatives. So much so that I'm not sure that the positives overrode all of the negatives of the show. And the negatives weren't like, oh my God, this is really, really bad. But the negatives were, this is kind of boring. All right. So once going back to my original thing, it's like, who is this for? So the character of Echo is not a big character, character in the comics. Yes, I'm sure every character has a fan following, but I would pay you money that I couldn't find 10 people who knew Echo, who knew who Echo was before this show came out or before Hawkeye came out. I mean, it's not something that's super popular enough to, for us to say, does it really need a show? So once again, I ask, who was this particular for? Now, I know Marvel likes to do, likes to be diverse in their particular characters. So maybe they chose this character because one, she was a female. Two, she was disabled. And three, she was Native American. So that does a lot for them to extend the diversity of their whole cinematic universe and all of their superhero characters. I absolutely get it. And I applaud them for picking a character like this. But overall, when you pick somebody who has all these things, if they're not popular, who are we doing this for? Because the character itself, as the way that they unveiled it in this particular show or this Marvel spotlight, which we'll get back to in a second, I didn't learn enough about to care about going forward. So this show wasn't for me, and it wasn't, oh, because I'm not a woman, disabled, or Native American, but it wasn't specifically for me not really knowing the character or where this character is going to go in the overall future. Now, with that being said, there were great things for the character. I think we learned those great things in Hawkeye. Not in this particular show. The only thing I got out of this particular show with this particular character was the whole beginning of her working for Fisk. The episode, and I believe it was the first episode or the second episode, and I forgive me which one it was, where they have her first mission, where she goes out with the other two underlings that are a little bit above her, kind of showing her the ropes, where that was a great action scene. And also we got a cameo from Daredevil. So she's got to hold her own with that, with Daredevil on screen and in a fight scene. I thought that was really, really good. But after that part, man, the story, just because it got more involved with the relationship with her family. And I know they're humanizing her and they're not just making her a killer and showing her gradual arc. But that part was really the most boring part of this thing. I mean, the grandfather was probably the more interesting character. And I wish I got to see more of the interaction between him and her and not so much the grandmother and the cousin or sister, niece, whatever, that was on screen. It just kind of kept me going. It was like, where are we going with this particular character? Other question that I have is, what are they going to do with this character in the long run of Marvel? Marvel is now doing what's called Marvel Spotlight. And we got a little of that earlier when we got the, where the Supernatural one with the, I forget what the name it was called when they did, when they showed all the killers and the hunters and stuff like that. Oh my God, I'm sorry, I don't remember it. And then we got like I Am Groot and the Guardians of the Galaxy Christmas special. All of those were Marvel Spotlight. But now going forward, Marvel has announced upcoming series that will end in one season. This one is one of those seasons. We're going to get stuff like Fantastic Four. We're going to get stuff like Blade. We're going to get stuff like the Thunderbolts. At least with those, I see the overall pattern or picture or path to where they're going with those particular shows. Even if they don't get a second series. This felt like it got to the beginning, it started at the beginning and it wrapped up, which for some people on a smaller character makes sense. But I felt like they wrapped up her story at the end of Hawkeye. I don't understand why we got another 5 episodes of this series of a character I felt I pretty much knew in Hawkeye. I liked it better as this character being a supporting character or a side character, kind of like the Tracksuit Mafia was in there, or kind of like a lot of other characters are in many other Disney shows and properties, where you learn enough about it and then you're kind of good. You feel like you know enough. Crossbones is a good example with Frank Grillo from Captain America Civil War all the way to I'm sorry, from Winter Soldier to Captain America Civil War. You got to see an arc of where he was in his character. I didn't need a 5-part episode of Crossbones and how he became Crossbones. Might have been interesting, but no, I didn't need it. So that was another question that I had about this. I don't understand what was the point of this. Who's going to rewatch this, you know, a year later from now, kind of finding out more of what Echo was, or even if Echo is even going to cameo in anything else going forward in the future. I think that this show probably didn't need to exist, and we should have went directly to either the Daredevil series, which it seems like they were definitely setting up with the post-credit scene, or just into Punisher. I would have cared more, and I know those two have already gotten seasons, and we didn't need to do another season to tell more, but I would have been more interested and more invested in something and a character I really cared about. Like, we could have really gone and found out where Wilson Fisk was, Kingpin was in this one, and how he matched up with Daredevil going forward, and how we're resetting the universe for this particular universe of Kingpin and Daredevil. Echo could have made a cameo in a flashback to explain, like, the original crossover that they first met before. Maybe Echo meets him later on, because we already established her as a hero at the end of Hawkeye. Anything else than what I got out of this particular show? Like I said, positives of it, it had a great setup in probably the first two episodes, 3, 4, and 5. It kind of just kept nosediving for me. And I, like, it wasn't bad. I just wasn't engaged or interested anymore, because I felt like they were beating me to death over her history on a character I really did not care about. All right. So those are my thoughts about Echo. Please tell me your thoughts in the comments below. I try to keep this short, not to ramble on too long, but please tell me what you guys thought about it. I've been seeing on the internet a lot of people kind of thought it was kind of all over the board with what people thought. Some people thought it was great. Some people thought it was horrible. Tell me what you guys think below. And if it's the first time that you're on the channel, make sure you subscribe as well as click the notification button so that way you're aware of all the other videos that we do on the channel. So with that being said, you guys take care.
Wait, guys, are you still here? I'm glad you're still here. All right, so if you look down, I mean, it's somewhere over here. Look down. We actually have a Patreon. So if you guys watch the show and you really like what we want to do and you want to help support the show and you want to help me get an editor so I can get to sleep at night because I'm really tired and you guys see all my mistakes in the episodes. So please go to patreon.com/thegoods. Give us a penny, give us a nickel, give us a dollar.
Don't give us the finger.
Don't do that. But make sure you do donate something because we do have some giveaways. There's posters, there's t-shirts.
I'll sign something for you.
Exactly. So take a look, guys, and help us out. We appreciate it.